Transitions are a part of an editor's lifeline. They allow you to move the pace of your narrative forward in interesting and dynamic ways, not to mention provide a number of utility-based techniques when you have to do before and after comparisons. And this is where Boris FX Continuum comes into play. With over 40 plus transitions that extend the capabilities of your NLE, this allows you to niche down, not to mention control the exact look and pace that you want. We'll see this by exploring a few different transitions in an unlikely category of the wipes that we have to offer. Let's see this all inside of Adobe Premiere Pro. All right, I'm here inside of Premiere Pro, and I have three of the same clip in a timeline with different effects on it. The actual sunset effect from Boris FX Continuum, a grad filter, and what I'd like to do is use a wipe to show the before and after. With all of our transitions, if we head over to the effects tab, in the video transitions category, you'll see BCC transitions and a whole lot to choose from. One of those is linear wipe, and this might be a bit deceitful because there are a lot of linear wipes in hosts that have limited controls. And with Continuum, there's quite a bit that you can use to make this effect your own. I'll grab linear wipe and apply it to the first edit point, move my playhead over to see that it kind of does look like a standard linear wipe. But the minute that we select it and head to our effect controls, we can see that there is a lot to control. Let's click on the effects editor badge at the top of the effect. And now we have a dedicated workspace to work with all of our BCC plus transitions. Over on the left-hand side are a series of presets that we can audition. And before we do that, in the viewer, I'm going to press the play button at the very bottom. We can see a green line revealing that this is now cached. And I can start to click through some of the transitions that are available to us as presets. You may be noticing as I click that the linear wipe changes direction, not to mention that in several cases, there is a border or thin line that drives the linear wipe forward. If we'd like, we could also do before and after comparisons. One way is to do an A-B comparison. Here's the original clip and our linear wipe, not to mention a vertical or horizontal comparison, seeing the original clip on the top, the transition added here on the bottom to the A and B segment. I'll just click on that button again to exit that mode. The exact same controls that we saw in the effect controls inside of Premiere Pro are mimicked here with our parameters on the right-hand side. Now, one thing that I want to draw your attention to is these on-screen controls that are available in almost every single BCC transition. They allow us to ease in and ease out of the transition, controlling the pace of how we enter it. If we head to the bottom of the parameter list, there's a section called Animation Tuning that has these two effects also dialed into a specific amount in this preset. If I hover over the middle of my viewer screen and grab the first line, you can see that I'm easing this in quite a bit more. And the impact of that in this particular case is that it will take its time leaving this side of the frame, eventually ramping up to full speed before it eases out just a little bit more subtly. Another thing we could do is reverse that altogether. We can have negative easing in values. If I ramp this all the way to negative 100 in this case, it's going to really speed out of when the transition starts, then slowly ramp down here more in the middle, and then ease a little bit towards the end. Obviously too aggressive for our purposes, and with any BCC parameter when working in the effects editor, you can simply reset that value to its default by clicking on the square icon next to the value. In this case, I'll just settle on an easing value of about 50. And let's bring this glow border wipe diagonal preset back inside of Premiere Pro by applying it. Now first, when we look inside of Premiere Pro, if you select the BCC linear wipe effect by its name, notice that the same on-screen controls that you saw inside the effects editor for animation tuning of easing in and easing out of this transition are available here. In addition to this, we see this line driving the wipe, which refer to our border controls. And one really unique thing is that we have up to three borders to choose from, all at this moment, which are activated. In several cases, we just use a very simple border to show before and afters here at Boris FX. So what I would do is go to my border 2 and border 3 and simply just bring down the opacity. So what we have is just the one border. Border 1, I'll increase that thickness. With any linear wipe, we can of course also rotate it and soften the way that the linear wipe is revealing the B clip. So if I disable borders, you can see how the softening value affects the edge of the wipe. Last but not least, with several BCC Plus transitions, we also have a color correction section, which will affect the color of your clips. Now, the cool part about this is that we could even ramp down to a full desaturated look at the middle of the transition before ramping back up to color if this was a desirable look. In this case, I'll just press Command Z a couple times to undo that. And with the border 1, let's also just change the color to a baby blue. I'll press OK. Head back into the effects editor just to show you that we could also save our own presets over in the parameter section. So at the very top is a create custom preset icon, the list. If we click on that, we can save out any preset that we want. In this case, I'll just type in baby blue 15. We can add some tags to make this easier to discover by doing searches here in the preset field, not to mention add a description. The best part about this is if I press OK, I can actually share this preset with another editor that has Continuum on their system, whether that be in Premiere Pro or any host that Continuum supports. All you have to do is right click on this preset, and this will open the custom preset location to where that's stored, and you'll see a lightweight XML file that you can then copy and paste to your desired location. I'll just press Apply to go back to Premiere Pro. And here inside of Premiere Pro, pretending that this is a different sequence, I'll head over to my Effects tab, Apply Linear Wipe, going to Effect Controls, and heading to the Effects Editor, I'll now see that Baby Blue 15 accessible here in alphabetical order. Once I apply that, I now have those two identical linear wipes here, revealing one clip after the other. I'll just do a full screen playback. Let's take a look at another example where we're going to use wipes more stylistically than as a utility effect that was shown here. In this sequence, I can see that the predominant color of the A side and the B side of the edit, there's quite a bit of blue. And I can actually use this blue color information to drive a wipe using BCC plus texture wipe. Let's move to our effects tab and select the BCC plus texture wipe transition from our transitions category. By selecting the transition and heading to effect controls, I can see that this is currently using the information from our source clip, which happens to be the A side of our edit or our outgoing clip, and it's using its luma information. If I step through this clip frame by frame, I can see that certain brighter luma values are being used to wipe off the clip first, followed by darker values until we see our reveal clip or the B side of the edit. Alternatively, I'm going to change the channel, in this case to blue. Let's see that full frame, followed by the predominant blue colors in our source clip. If you're unhappy with the way that these colors wipe off, we could also play around with our blur, as well as softness and choke values to end up with our different result based on the color information selected. Another thing we can do is also invert the wipe. And in this case, still using the source clip, the only difference is the blue from the heart balloons wipe off first, followed by the background color. Last but not least, instead of using the source clip or the outgoing clip, we could head to the texture map and choose to reuse the reveal clip instead. And since this is set to invert, if I make this full frame, we've got our blue hearts first, and then the blue texture from our incoming shot being used to drive the wipe. Like we did before, we can play around with the blur at the softness as well as the choke. And if we want to, we could also use both texture maps, our A side and our B side, by choosing mix in this case. So both of the blue colors from these shots are being used to drive the wipe. Showing one more example of this, I'm just going to hop over into another sequence called Texture Wipe 2, where green is the predominant color. And we can see here, over the transition, what happens is the subject in the B shot is revealed because the luminant levels in the background are wiped off first, followed by the green colors in the foreground of the dancing subject there in the wide shot. If I take a close look at the parameters of this effect by selecting the transition, we can see the texture map is currently inverted the wipe, set to the green channel and using the source clip. Of course, we can uninvert this, which would have the subject wipe off first before revealing our B-side subject or the incoming clip. And just like we did in the other example, I can change the texture map to reveal. And in this case, we can see that our subject that has predominantly green colors in her dress in the B shot is what's being used to drive the wipe. And just like our linear wipe transition, we also have animation tuning as well as color correction controls that we can take advantage of here in this effect. If I select texture wipe by its name, here are the ease in and ease out controls. Let's take a look at that transition one more time. Excellent. Over 40 plus transitions inside of Boris FX Continuum. This is a collection that's going to extend that capability of your nonlinear editor, giving you a lot of choice for both utility and stylistic purposes. For more tips and tricks just like this, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you here sometime soon.